Good day and welcome to the Sport Rep Show. I'm your host, Limba Mupetami. Let's start the show off with the hit list. Tura Magic Football Club stand-in coach Timo Chongarero has said that they have a youthful squad and they are not going to put any pressure on them in their challenge for the Deep Marine Namibia Premiership title. Tura Magic are currently 11th on the log with 1 point from 2 matches played in the 16th team campaign. MTC Salute Boxing Academy Executive Chairman Kiriata Kamanya has said that the future of boxing in Namibia lies in the hands of amateur boxers, hence the need for all boxers and boxing stables in the country to join forces and develop junior fighters. Moving onwards, Namibian boxer Emmanuel Mungandjela says there is no pressure to win the vacant WBC International Super Lightweight title on Saturday against Pierce O Leary of the United Kingdom. Well, the Namibian Eagles are currently fourth on the ICC's Cricket World Cup League 2 log with 30 points, while the USA are third with 33. The USA beat Namibia the previous Sunday in their first ODI of the Castle Light Tri-Series at Wanderers by 71 runs. Saturday's ODI will be a real test for the Namibian captain and his charges. It is the key for the Eagles to outperform the USA to reach 32 points on the log. This will be the USA's last match of the CWCL2 series, while Namibia got 10 left to reach 36 games. The United Arab Emirates are real danger to Namibia as they sit in fifth position and are chasing third spot with 27 points. Here's a recap action from Namibia and USA's match. That ends the hit list. Up next is the Zoom In segment of today's show, but quickly, an ad break. Namib Desert Diamonds announced a sponsorship commitment of 445,000 towards Namibia's Hockey Fives team set to compete at the Africa Cup of Nations tournament in Egypt from the 10th till the 15th of December. The African tournament will serve as a World Cup qualifying event for the nations competing. Egypt, Namibia, South Africa, Kenya and Zambia will battle in the women's division. Jesse Jackson Carrider was at the press conference and compiled this for us. Take a look at this.
Good morning to everyone. I know that we had our prize giving last night. We had celebrated recognizing our under-18s, our team that went to Ghana, our team that went to Zimbabwe. You know, hockey is in an extremely healthy state at the moment. But just before I kick off, I'd like to just, from a protocol perspective, all protocols observed. Thank you, Mr. Moya. I know that you're always very welcoming and lead us well. And then also the Deputy Minister, Ms. Emma Kantema-Kalmes. Thank you for honoring us with your presence. My message is quite short. I think, as always, and at an event like this, right, now, I'm extremely proud of our girls, our boys, our men, our women hockey teams. We've really performed way beyond what I believe a country of our small population. We're becoming very well known in Africa and even around the world that little Namibia, Namibia's name has been put on the map because of your efforts. So I'm very proud of our team. And as a start, I'm going to announce the team to celebrate your selection, but also to remind you that you are representing Namibia. And remember my words always, you know, it's a proud thing to represent, but it's a huge responsibility. You carry our nation on your shoulders, and you must carry it in your hearts as well. So represent us well. With that, I'm going to start by announcing, first of all, the captain of the team, which is the one and only Petro Stoffer. Also, there's Petro.
Okay.
Also an amazing goalkeeper. You know, I saw her do a save in the test series against South Africa recently because of a short corner. Wow, that those reflexes are amazing. So let's hope that we'll see some more of that in Egypt. Then our vice captain is Yavanka Kriya. Then the rest of the team, Barentia Diamond, Jean-Toi Clear, Charlize Ricks, Armin van Staden, Kayla Schimming, Danya Meyer, Anthea Kutsia. And then obviously that's the team that's going to be representing us on the field, and our management under the leadership of our coach, proud coach, Mr. Evan Andura. Well done, Evan, and all the best on the field. Okay? Then our manager, Ms. Kimber Leroux. And our VA is Ms. Marika Short. So that's our team that will be presenting us in Egypt between 10 and 15 December in a city called Ismailia. I don't know where that is. I've never been there. So good luck. I'm sure you're going to be under Arvin and the management's guide. Then on a further note, very important that this is made possible through the sponsorships. Now, I know that the Namibian community, we always go, we're an amateur sport, and it's there's a lot of costs involved. As you would know, flight tickets, accommodation, just subsistence, there's a lot of financial commitment required. And with that, I want to thank Namibia. Really, we depend and we are extremely grateful to organizations like yourself, truly Namibian, that support us as Namibians representing our country. We really thank you very much. Then just two things just from my perspective. I know that this is a new form of hockey. You might be used to the indoor, which where we've excelled quite a bit. You might be used to field that we're now playing on Astros. But what's quite important, this new form of hockey, and if you look at the other sports types, whether it is soccer, and what football, five-a-side, or whether it is cricket from the test series to the one days to the night cricket, the 2020 cricket. Now, this fives, why I feel that we really need to support this. Here you've got smaller teams. You know, you can have smaller facilities. So from a grassroots levels up, instead of having 11 players against 11, on huge facilities, I think this is a more powerful form of the game. We always have to consider when it's shorter and more compact that we've got to concentrate on the health and safety around what we're doing as well.
Well, moving on, we have the Spotify segment, which is the youth sports section. So let's get into it right after this short break. The Rodax Max Challenge Namibia National Karting Championship held in Sokopmund produced winners in different classes. Winner of the Junior Max class, Kwas Renicki, who was in a class of his own, said that his trophy was not that hard to get thanks to his new kart. Stay tuned for the highlight package.
Hello viewers, I'm joined by
Jack.
Okay. We had quite an interesting day today, and I'm pretty sure that the races also had a lot of fun today. Can you just tell us from the side of the organizers how the event went overall?
Yeah, we had the eighth national of our national Rotax national karting championship, mm-hmm. and the championship is wrapped up now. It was quite a nice event. Mm-hmm. Really some good racing. We had about 34 entrants. Mm-hmm. Which is for our standards quite well. We were last year we had about 20-25, uh-huh. So the sport is growing. From an organizer's point, from today up, I'm actually quite happy. Mm-hmm. There's always some small stuff that needs or can be improved.
Yeah.
We always work on it, but it's a good wrap up, and we're happy, and we had no injuries, and so I think very good racing. So I'm happy.
Up next is Spot Rep's special World Cup segment. This is where we speak about different aspects of the World Cup. Right after the break, we will delve into the World Cup's top goal scorer. So please stay tuned for that. Between 2002 and 2014, Germany's Miroslav Klose set a world record for the most World Cup goals. With 16 goals across four World Cups, Klose ranks as the top scorer in the tournament's history. He's also Germany's outright best, with 71 strikes in 137 international appearances. Whilst Brazil's Ronaldo no longer holds the record as top scorer at the World Cup, his tally of 15 goals in just 19 appearances across three tournaments is rightly admired. With that, we have a short video clip of Namibian track and field coach Henk Botha sharing his sentiments, or rather his predictions, on the ongoing World Cup with his money set on Senegal, or rather Belgium, he said. Well, anyway, just have a look at this video and see for yourself as to what he has to say about the ongoing World Cup.
Good day, everybody. I'm Coach Henk Botha, and yes, we are all excited on the Soccer World Cup in Qatar. And everybody is hanging on the television and live streaming and just can't wait for their team to play. My team, obviously, and the World Cup would be the African teams. My first choice would be Senegal because I'm a big Liverpool fan, and the great Vani that played for Liverpool is part of the Senegal team, and I think Senegal can make us proud as Africans, and we will see them definitely in the playoffs. We'll definitely support them and stick with them. And then obviously the second African team, Tunisia, that's also there. And in Tunisia we have Wahbi Khazi, that is one of their favorite players to watch out for. And then obviously there's a lot of teams that people say, and that even the bookies are saying, that will make the finals. But in my opinion, I think it's all open for any team to go through. I think a team like Poland, actually, which is not ranked very highly, can make a couple of big surprises in this coming World Cup in Qatar. And then obviously the big names like France, Brazil, Germany, and let's see what England can do. We know that a lot of English supporters believe this is their year, and England might be able to not choke this World Cup, so let's see. And in the England side we have Gareth Southgate and Harry Kane, two of the names that we can watch out for. But if I need to support somebody out of Africa, it'll definitely be the Dutch, the Netherlands team, and obviously the Netherlands a well-known and very highly competitive team within the World Cup. We also have Germany, which I believe in Namibia will be highly supported because of our German heritage and a lot of German people still staying in Namibia. So Germany is also one of the teams that we can look out for to be in the finals. As far as the Dutch is concerned, we can look out for Memphis Depay and Virgil van Dijk. Those are the two guys I think will stand out in this World Cup. And obviously we have Portugal with Cristiano, the controversial Cristiano Ronaldo. We have Argentina with Messi, one of the greatest players ever. And we'll definitely see great soccer, and please enjoy the soccer. And let's root for our teams. Have a nice festive season, and please be safe on the roads. Thank you very much.
Well, viewers, if you're watching the show right now, and of course, if you're following the World Cup, South Korea playing Uruguay at the moment, 0-0 that match is. Later on at 6 o'clock, we have Portugal going up against Ghana. Well, of course, the African countries haven't scored a goal yet in the World Cup. Let us know what your predictions are. Let us know who is going to go through from the group stages. Now, that ends the World Cup segment. Up next is Ari Hochert bringing us international sports news in detail. So please stay tuned for that.
Good day everyone, time for international sports news, and starting off with men's team tennis. It's Davis Cup tennis that's being played in Malaga in Spain, and it is the home team that lost. It is Croatia that is through to the semi-final. They won the quarterfinals game against Spain by 2-0, both the singles games. So that is the Croatia that's going through to play against Australia after Australia beat the Netherlands. In what happened in the games was, first it was Borna Kuric that beat Roberta Bogesta Agu of Spain by 6-4 and 7-5. And then the big clincher was Martin Cilic that beat Pablo Correa Busta, and he beat him in 3 hours. It was a long game. He beat him by 5-7, 6-3 and 7-6. And it is Croatia that won the title in 2018, trying to win the Davis Cup again. Other four teams are still also in the quarterfinals is Italy and USA, and Germany and Canada. They're fighting out for a place in the semi-final. Moving on to some netball news. It is the Spar Diamond Challenge that's currently being played, international tournament being played in Pretoria at the University of Pretoria. And the news from the tournament is that South Africa beat Zimbabwe quite convincingly by 72-37. And also the South African President's team, they were in action against Scotland, a very competitive game there. It was the South African President's team that won 49-48. Earlier in the week, it was South Africa that beat Scotland as well, and the President's team also beat Zimbabwe. Continuing international sports news with rugby news, two internationals being played over the weekend. That is a part of the European international season. It will be Australia that will play against Wales. So that game will be played at the Principality Stadium in Cardiff, and also the Springboks, South African Springboks, that play against England in Twickenham. News from Australian camp is that they have lots of injuries. They have 7 injuries from their last game against Ireland. And the two most high-profile players that won't be able to play this weekend is the flanker Michael Hooper. He's out with an injury. And earlier in the week, it was also announced that the scrum half Nick White is also out with concussion. It is Australia that lost their previous game against Ireland, 13-10. But it's also Wales that had a difficult weekend. The past weekend, they lost to Georgia. That was a big surprise. So it is Wales that want to make this right when they play Australia. That will be on Saturday, and the kickoff in that game will be 5:05 Southern African time. The Springboks play against England at Twickenham. They don't have injuries, but they have many of their players that need to go back to club duty. This game falls outside the international window for Test rugby. There is good news for South Africa in that centre, Damian D'Alenda. He was on Monday couldn't train because he had the injury strain, but he was cleared and he will be able to play against England in that game on Saturday. The kickoff in that game will be 7:30 Southern African time. And to close off today's international sports news, it is motor racing news, Formula One racing news, and it is Red Bull that confirmed that Daniel Ricciardo of Australia will join Red Bull team from next year, the 2023 season, as their third driver. And already, of course, the Red Bull do have Max Verstappen as their number one. He's the winner of the 2022 season. And Sergio Perez, he came in third overall. He's the second driver for Red Bull. Daniel Ricciardo, he was racing for McLaren this year in the 2022 season. Didn't have a good season. He finished 11th overall with 37 points. And he was outdone quite a bit by Lando Norris. He's a teammate, Lando Norris, after finished 7th on 122 points. That was after the conclusion of the 24 races of this season. Now that is international sports news for today. Hope you have a great sport day, and we talk international sport again tomorrow. Goodbye.
That ends today's Sport Rep Show. We will be back again tomorrow, same place, same time.